It would be very nice to have like a gentleman fragrance with a touch of lavender. That would be very comforting. Oh, great. Thanks, Tom.
I'm Tom Ford. I'm a fashion designer.
Bonjour fragrance lovers, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we are doing a 10-minute review on Tom Ford Beau de Jour, the newest edition, so the one from the signature collection and not the one from the private blend that we used to have before. So when I first saw that Tom Ford was launching a Beau de Jour again, I was like very interested. I couldn't wait to smell it, and for me the name evokes something that is going to be an all-time classic for men during the day, and probably I was expecting also, seeing the color of the bottle, that very like green tone, I was really expecting something definitely gentleman-like, just like a barbershop fragrance, because the look of it really made me think of that. So is it a nice gentleman scent? Is it perfect for daytime? What is it about? Is it a barbershop fragrance? Let me guide you. First of all, let's talk about the composition. So we have on the top note, and this is really what we get at the beginning, a bomb of lavender. That's only because you have lavender and lavender, pure extract of fresh lavender, which is really nice. I love lavender because it always gives me that very soothing and relaxing freshness, and it also makes me think of old-fashioned scent, which I'm going to talk about. So that was for me a really nice surprise. However, I'm always like a bit... always get to be bored of lavender scent. I think for me it's quite difficult to wear nowadays, so I was really curious. And then you have this aromatic heart that really makes me think of a garden, an aromatic garden, because you have rosemary, basil and mint, and rosemary always have that slight mintiness at the beginning, so that's why in the ingredients breakdown they're very similar to mint. All about aromats in this fragrance. And then the dry down, it's got a little bit of amber and patchouli, which is for me ultra discreet. For me the trail was really discreet. You can't really smell it at the beginning. It's really after a few minutes, hours, that you can really smell that backbone. So it's not really here to be the fragrance. It's here to give, I would say, for me a more luxurious atmosphere in the fragrance. If it was just the scent of lavender, that would be quite common. The opening at first sight for me, the first time I smelled it, was pretty tough to me, because it's really a bomb of that minty freshness, lavender like, that is there, and I was like, oh, how can you wear that every day? For me that was really like a heavy lavender scent. Let's talk about how it makes me feel now. So we've seen in the fragrance community those months at the beginning of 2020 a lot of lavender scent going on the screen, I would say. We've seen Jo Malone, for example, launching like three or four, I don't remember, of lavender scent, and there was a lot of brands like surfing on that trend vibe. So when I've seen that, I was like, okay, they want to go through that vibe of lavender that is the new in ingredient at the moment. So I was like, compared to the scent I've smelled, I think this one's got much more luxurious tone. You know, it's not just a little cologne for every day. It's got really a nice complexity in the ingredient, which is really nice. When I smell it, I really get that complexity, so it guides me through different ingredients with the time, which is really nice. So in general, it smells very clean, ultra clean fragrance, very herbaceous as well, and for me it's definitely for spring summer wear, or maybe fall maybe, but I won't wear lavender scent during winter, because for me it's a bit too minty and cooling, so it's a very cool scent. And I think when you're in winter, you want something more warmer. But for this season, definitely a yes. Does it really makes me think of a barbershop fragrance? 100%. When I smelled it, the first time that things that come to my mind is, you know, when you shave the beard and you apply some aftershave lotion and a little massage in the barbershop. This really made me think of that. This very dandy style. It's very also sparkling, classic, elegant, and it makes me feel of think of the vintage vibe. I'm really into vintage scent personally. I think, for example, like a Pour Monsieur au Bois du Portugal from Creed, a really old-time classic. And before, we used to say that the gentleman scent was really smelling ultra masculine, like the barbershop cleanness, very clean fragrance, usually a bit lemony, woody, but very fruity, like always mixed with some aromatic like lavender. And it used to, so the category of that fragrance usually of fougère. Just a little bit precision about fougère. It means fern-like in French. It's an olfactive family that is composed strictly by coumarin, lavender and moss. But you have a lot of different categories of fougère. So strictly, Beau de Jour is not a fougère, but one of its family friends. Scent, so like Platinum Egoist from Chanel, for example, or Tom Ford already did some fougère, like Fougère d'Argent. Those kind of fougère, for me, are difficult to approach. It's a category of fragrance I'm not really keen about because I'm a lady, and this is really a category that for me is the hardest to wear as a lady. I think you can't wear that really as a lady because it smells, for me, ultra gentleman-like, and it really smells just like you've been shaving or something, so I don't want to smell like that. But on a man, I have to say it's really classic and elegant, and I do really appreciate it on men. And I really love that fashion is a circle, and the fact that we are coming back to scent like this, that are very gentleman, for me it's lovely, because nowadays really the trend of bismuth fragrance, a lot of amber oriental vibe, which I absolutely love, but I do love that kind of scent for men. I think for daytime wear it's very gentleman. This one kind of like bring on both sides, because for me it's quite like bismuth, this fragrance, like especially at the beginning, for me it's got a massive opening, and then it dries down to something a bit more discreet and really nice for day and office friendly for me. But at the beginning it's really a lot. I really enjoy the fact that Tom Ford modernized a bit the old school vibe gentleman scent, which I think was needed, so it's really pretty. And I think for me it's got really that luxurious tone, so I would say for me it would begin one of the men's essential fragrance, this kind of fragrance, like fougère scent. It's something that you need as a man, I think, because it's a clean freshness, very masculine, so I think it's nice to get. But you need to enjoy fougère scent, and I know it's not a category that is easy, the most easiest to wear for me. A lot of people said that it looks a bit like Zino Davidoff. I think for me, Davidoff is a bit more weaker and not as luxurious as this one. And also people said that it looked like, what was that? YSL Rive Gauche. I was like, not really for me. Rive Gauche is much more complex. It does have a vibe, but for me, it's quite different. I think this one is more romantic and soothing and relaxing and comforting. For me, is a great addition to the Tom Ford's range, because they didn't have sort of fougère as fresh and clean like that. So I think it's nice. And the longevity for me, I felt, was pretty good as well. It's not, of course, the best, because come on guys, it's an aromatic scent. It's not gonna last as long as your usual bismuth oud fragrance, which is totally fair and normal. It's a daytime fragrance, office friendly for me, so that's normal. But would I purchase it myself? No, because I'm a lady and it's too masculine. Would I like a man to wear this fragrance? 100%. I think it's really elegant with a casual chic, you know, atmosphere. I felt it's not that very unique, like if scent that we've seen before, modernized old school scent, but we've seen it before, so it's not very unique to me. but it's a really pretty scent. I did really appreciate it. So after that, it's up to you. If you don't have a fougère in your collection, it might worth it, because for me, it's a really nice fougère and I'm usually non-keen on fougère. I think my favorite one is definitely Platinum Egoist from Chanel, but it's not as aromatic as this one would be. I think for me, that's a great scent to have, but again, it's not the most unique, but that was the aim with this fragrance. I think it didn't aim to be that unique. It needs to be, I think, a men's essential. So I think for that, it wins a little bit of point. That's for sure. If I would give it a grade, I would give it a good 8 over 10, I think, for me, because it's really nicely done, and compared to what I was expecting, it was exactly that. I was scared at the beginning, but with some time, really got to appreciate this fragrance. So yes, so that's it for me. Tell me in the comments, what do you think of this fragrance? Did you like it? Did you enjoy it? What do you think of it? I would be curious to hear what you think about it as a gentleman and as a lady, of course, if you have tried. I would say it's not a blind buy. Nothing is a blind buy to me anyway, but just try it before, because challenging category, the fougère for sure. Don't forget to leave me a little like, subscribe to my channel if you didn't do it yet, and join me on Instagram as well, because I think I'm gonna make you participate in some question time soon. So I will see you there, and bye now.